Hi guys, it's me Karen and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do a page in Wildflower Folk by Christine Karen. And I'm going to do this page here. I've got out the Artex alcohol markers. We're going to start off with 132, probably the only one I'm going to use for base on the skin, and then I'll use pencils for the rest. So we're just going to go in and add color here. So how are you all doing? I hope you're doing well. Had an interesting week, so I apologize for not getting many videos done. My daughter had a little issue with an allergic reaction to some laundry soap that we had picked up. We were at Costco and they had a sale on what was it? Tide Free and Clear, I believe it's called. So we thought we'd try it because I have sensitive skin myself. I should put a piece of paper behind here. I haven't had much trouble with it bleeding through. This paper is really thick. Anyway, so we picked it up, and of course I had to finish the last pile of laundry detergent we had. If you know Costco, they come in big tubs. So we had been using just the regular Tide and thought that the Tide Free and Clear might be a good choice. Well, that was a big to-do here. There's something in it that my daughter is allergic to. Didn't bother my skin, but boy, did it bother hers. So we had, she got a complete total welted rash all over her where any of her skin got in contact with the soap on the clothing. So it's residue from when you wash. Wasn't touching the pods themselves. It was just when I washed them, and that was how it happened. So we weren't sure to begin with. And then we had to, of course, spend a couple of days washing every item in her room. Bedding, pillows, mattress pads, I mean, every item of clothing, towels, washcloths, basically anything that could absorb some of that soap residue. And I mean, any type, any kind, a little bit. I'm going to put a little pink here, and this is number 137. So yeah, washing everything was just a lot of washing to be done. So I've spent a lot of time doing that. And after, 3 days, the rash is finally gone. I remember doing this when I was a kid. My grandmother had made me a beautiful feather quilt for the birthday. And I had woken up and I was in a total head-to-toe rash. I'm going to mix these two together when I'm adding the pink so it blends. So that's 137 and 132. So yeah, we had to do all of my bedding. I think we even got rid of my mattress when I was little. And unfortunately, I had to get rid of the quilt, which I absolutely loved. But couldn't risk what was going on with my skin at that point. So, kind of knew what was going to go on here when it happened to her. Poor thing. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. I like this pink. It's pretty. Maybe we'll do our fingernails in it. Poking myself with everything. Okay. We're going to do her sweater in pink. So we might as well just use this pretty pink and add in some here. Just going to kind of go over where it's the darkest. Mr. Thumb there. So better do that. And I guess that's part of her hand too. Okay, oh, we'll do this little thing in her hair the same color. Scrunchy. And we'll throw a little of it in this feather. There we go. So far we've only used the two colors. Don't know better eyes. Her hair is going to be kind of a brownish color, so I kind of want to get a light brown. Don't know which one's light brown. Boom. Pull out a piece of paper. That's not light brown. That's real light. That's not gonna work. Don't know if you're brown. Oops, close enough. Okay, this is 169. And we're just gonna pull it in here. Okay. I kinda wanna do her eyes with a pink tint to it, so we're gonna put the pink in there. Book is gonna be dark red, but we're gonna throw pink. It's the lightest color down in here. And we'll use that brown a little bit in the pages down here. And they could go in here too. Boom, boom, boom. Close. Okay, then I'm gonna get some pencils and we will get to work on it. Okay, we're gonna work on her skin. I'm gonna bring in the light flash. It's 132. If you have a newer set, it's called something else. Sorry. Just concentrating on where I'm putting that pencil. Kind of everywhere, there's a little shadow area. Okay, we're going to bring in a little of the cinnamon. Last time I used it, I got sparkles on the tip, so I have to sharpen that. Then we're just going to darken a few areas. Just using that very lightly. Just a little more shadow on this side of the face than the other. A little more of that light flesh on her chin. We have buff titanium. Licky, licky, I got a big one. I don't have to hurt my fingers anymore. So we're just going to buff this in. Okay, we're going to darken up her lips a little bit. I don't want them reddish. I want them to match the book cover, so Caput Mortem is coming in here very lightly. It's going to be okay. We're going to do a little of that in her eyes too. Then we'll throw a little brown in there, but we're going to start with a burnt sienna. She's still going to give us our red color. In a little bit of bister in there. Black for her pupils. Sharpen that, get a little bit more eyelashes on there. So we're going to tilt the book a little bit, sorry. Turn the pencil to get the sharpest points here. I have to turn the book the other way for this one. I want the eyelashes to go the right direction. Since there aren't any showing here. That looks better, but I mean, it is what it is. If I can find my eraser, where did it go? I can just curl those just a little bit more there. They gotta stay underneath the glasses. The frame will frame them out there. Okay, we're gonna get blue. I like to do it in blue, so light phthalo blue is what I'm gonna use here. Put a little blue in the whites of her eyes. Then go in with the white Holbein. What do I have here? I want the 501. Trying to find it. Here it is. Okay, we're just gonna blend that. Got to her teeth too, so and that 5 o'clock. Got a little tooth there. We're going to add in with a little black so you see it, and then we will take a little gray. And just blend that in. Just touch it up. Soften that black line a little. Boom. Okay. I'm gonna throw a little cinnamon up in here. Okay, then we'll get a white Posca pen. Oh boy. Can we open this? We'll think about it. That's just gonna take a while. It's in a plastic wrap. And I have to shake it. I bought a new set. Seems like the thing I buy all the time. So this is a 0.7 pin type. So it has a pin nip. So I have to shake that up. Always a good idea to put the lid back on when you do that. And then prep it by pushing down a few times until it comes out. Which I probably should do off camera, but you never know how long it takes to do this. Do, 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 do. Come on. Boop, 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 boom. There we go. All right. I'm gonna put some dots on her eyes. When we do her glasses, there'll be a white shine coming down here to cover some of her eyes up. So don't get too worried about getting it perfect, although you can. Black there. All right. Let's see. I think I'll work on her shirt because we can use the same colors here. This one. This is a Holbein cherry blossom. A nice light pink. We're going to use that to go in here first. Love this pink pencil. I've moved a couple of the Holbeins permanently into my Polychromos case. And of course, the buff titanium lives in there too. But this is a nice soft pink. Which I can't find in the other case. Or the polychromos, you can get pretty good with the light flesh, but it turns at a different, more yellow tone. And I want the pink pink. So there's that one, and then its companion to make it darker is the rose pink. So you can go in, and these both live in my case. The polychromos. Go in and put a darker shadow in there. And then, of course, use the white Holbein 501 to give the highlights. So we're going to do that after we're done here. Okay, then we're going to go in with the Holbein 501 and just lighten any of these areas that you want to bring out a highlight in. Also soften up the look of the shirt. And we'll do this little scrunchie. And also put in the white highlights in this. wherever you think they should be. Because it is one of those crunchy thingies. Okay, we're going to bring in the caput mortuum down here into the book area. Just going to go over it lightly with the pencil, try to get some texture off of the paper. Literally, I want to use that texture to make this look a little more leather-like. Okay, we're going to do the other side. Bring in a brown. What did I have out here? Burnt sienna. Add a lighter color brown, throw in a little bit of brown ochre, just in a few spots to brighten some of that up. put some of this in this corner pieces. There's another quarter piece, so we're not putting it there. Did I bring out like a bister or anything? I thought I did. Don't know where I put it. Yep, here we are. Want that corner a little redder. This could put Mortem Violet. Bister. So working between the two colors. putting in some hash lines here. And then going over them gently, adding a little texture. Without too much. Sorry, we're getting there. It's gonna take a while. Burnt sienna. Okay, I'm going to have to stop the video now. I'll leave it as is. We'll take a picture of it and leave it at the end of the video. And we will see you in part two. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section down below. And I'll get to them as soon as I can. Hope you're enjoying. And have a wonderful day, guys. Bye now.